During the proceedings, Zimola requested bail due to heart health concerns, which the judge denied. Instead, he was advised to contact welfare officers at Buwambo for possible transfer to Maction Bay in Luzira for medical attention. Judge Nahilia adjourned the case until November 28th for further discussion, sending both individuals to Buwambo prison while the state attorney prepares the case. The incident occurred on October 27th after 1-1 draw between UPDF and Express FC game in Bombo, and Sekaiva, who was one of the assistant referees, was allegedly intercepted in Matuga, dragged out of the car and beaten. FUFA spokesperson Ahmed Hussein commented on the situation, emphasizing the importance of addressing such violent behavior in football.
It's a game that is full of emotions, and we believe that without emotions, the game can't be so interesting, but the criminality part cannot be entertained in the game of football. And when it is a crime, that means you are against the state. And we believe that our fans need to understand that message. We're going to play a big role as FUFA to make sure we continue sensitizing the media, sensitizing every stakeholder, to sensitize even the fans, who are also very, very important on the match day, because without them inside the stadium, then there's no football. We don't want to have empty stadiums. We don't want potential sponsors, even the current sponsors, to run away because of high levels of hooliganism. So the amended article, of course, will help us to curb the high levels of hooliganism. And we believe that the fans will pick the message. We shall play a bigger role in sensitizing them.
The next hearing is scheduled for November 28th, where the state attorney will present the case against the accused individuals.